Welcome to ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D. In this video, you'll learn how to create basic GD&T inspections. I'll show you how to inspect some of the dimensions, positions, and a surface profile. GD&T inspections can be performed with and without CAD data in your project, so we'll have a look at both options. If you want to try ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D, take a look at the description below. There, you'll find links to download the software, request a free trial, and download training data. Like I said before, we'll look at GD&T inspections with and without CAD data. Let's start with actual data only. I'll quickly import the mesh of my part and create an alignment. I'll use the 3-2-1 alignment. Use Control and the left mouse button to click three points to define the Z plane. Two points to define a line in Y direction, and one point for X. To evaluate actual data, you usually have a drawing, like this one, specifying your inspection tasks. We'll check the length of the base plate as indicated in the drawing. Here's how to do that. Open iInspect, either in the main toolbar or by using Control and the right mouse button. Then, open GD&T Quick Creation. Here, you'll find all the inspections we'll be using throughout this tutorial. Select Dimension Independency Principle. This check allows you to construct elements such as planes, cylinders, and spheres. Because I want to inspect the length of the training object, I'll create two planes, one on either side of the part. Press and hold Control and click the element you want to create. Choose the element you want to create, in this case, fitting plane. Then click the plane on the other side. When you're done creating the elements required for your check, click the right mouse button to open the dialog window for the check. On a side note, if you open a function and don't know what to do, have a look at the tooltip down here. It'll show you the different options and commands you need. Okay, back to the check. Up here, you can change the name of the check. Now remember, you not only create a check, but also the base element or base elements for the check. If you want to rename the base element, click this button here. In this case, it's green because we're working with actual data only, and actual data is marked by a green icon. If you're creating the elements on CAD data, it's blue, but you'll see that in a moment. Since you're working with actual data only, you need to enter the nominal length here. For this example, it's 400 millimeters. And you need to set the tolerance manually to 0.1 millimeters. Click OK to create the check, and you're done. As you can see, the label displays the minimum and maximum distances between the two planes. You can also see where the two distances are located on your part. The distance with the arrows facing out represents the minimum distance. The distance with the arrows facing in represents the maximum distance. Okay, let's talk about option two, dimensional inspections with CAD data. I'll simply import the CAD and create a pre-alignment. If you watched the tutorial, How to Perform Simple Inspections, you might remember the importance of alignments in ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D. You need an alignment to transform the datasets into a common coordinate system. For GD&T inspections, no special alignment is required because the ZEISS inspections are based on local elements on actual data. Therefore, there's no dependency to any directions. Let's perform the inspections highlighted in this drawing. If you look closely, you'll see that two of the checks reference a datum system, BC. So let's create that first. Open GD&T Quick Creation, create datum system. You can create the elements required for the datum system directly in this dialog. Just click Create Fitting Element. I'll create the datum plane B first. Use Control and the left mouse button to click the plane you want to create. Click the right mouse button to finish the element creation and name the plane B to reference the drawing. Repeat this for plane C. Check that the name of the datum system is BC. Then click Create and Close. And here's the datum system. I'll change the display settings in the properties to show only the coordinate system, just because it makes my life a little easier later. Next, let's inspect the four cylinders in the corners. As you can see in the drawing, we need to check their diameter and position. Now with the position tolerance come two conditions. We need to check the position with regards to the datum system BC, which we just created, and the position must be checked as a common zone, meaning the tolerance of 0.1 millimeters refers to an element group consisting of the four cylinders. This may sound complicated on paper, but it's super easy to realize in the software. Let's start with the diameter check. As you already saw previously, the functions under GD&T Quick Creation allow you to select a check and then construct the elements required for that check. When you have CAD data in your project, you can construct all the elements on the CAD data, and the software will automatically use a measuring principle to compute the corresponding elements on your actual data, just like it did for the datum system we created. To inspect the cylinder diameter, select Dimension, Envelope Principle. When you have CAD data, you can press and hold Control and move the cursor around the part to see a preview of the elements you can create. To create the first cylinder, click the left mouse button. Because we're going to use the same check and tolerances on the other three cylinders, you can create them as well. Click the right mouse button to finish the element creation. Now, because we're creating multiple elements, we can choose to create separate elements or an element group. With element group, you can apply a combined or separate tolerance or a check for each element, which is what we want in this case. But because we need to evaluate the four cylinders as a common zone for the position check, I'll create an element group right away. This way, we can use the same element group also for the position check. Once you select an option, the dialog window for the check opens. To check each cylinder separately, select Check per element. Enter the tolerance and click OK to create the check for all four cylinders. And here are the results. Now, for the position check, select the element group we just created. Open GD&T Quick Creation, Position. Under Datum System, select the datum system BC. To do that, you can use Control and the left mouse button and select it in the 3D view. Or you can use the drop-down list and search field. If you haven't created the required datum system yet, you can do it directly through this dialog by clicking this button here. Under Tolerance Zone, Type, select Circular, and keep the default of ZZ, or Common Zone, as required by the drawing. Enter the tolerance of 0.1 millimeters. Then click OK to create the check. Before we move on to another GD&T inspection, let's adjust the visualization of the results we already have. With ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D, you can match the visualization in the drawing with ISO 3D labels. To change the labels, select the elements and checks in the project. Open iInspect and under Edit, Visualization, select ISO 3D. You can also set the ISO 3D labels as your default. To do that, open Edit, Manage Templates. In the drop-down list, select Element Properties. Then change the default to ISO 3D. In addition to ISO 3D labels, you can stamp your inspections. Stamps are inspection feature IDs that make communication easier Each feature has a number you can refer to when talking to colleagues and customers about a specific feature. To use stamping, also called ballooning, simply rename the checks to a number or a sequence of numbers separated by dots or dashes. You could do that manually by selecting a check, using F2 and renaming it to a number, but I'd only recommend doing that when you first create the check. Then the software will continue with numbers as naming scheme for future checks. But if you want to rename multiple existing checks, like I do, there's a much easier way. Select all the checks you want to stamp. Open Operations, Elements, Define Inspection Balloons. In this dialog, you can sort elements by type or base element, for example, which can be useful when you have element groups. If the numbering you want cannot be achieved with the sorting options, you can change the order of elements with drag and drop. For more information about this dialog, consult the tech guide. When you click OK, you'll see a little stamp appear beside the check. Please note that you need to use ISO 3D labels to see the stamps. You can also show the results and stamps in the table. Just be aware that to see the stamps, you need to use or create a table template that contains the column name. You can use the template VDA, for example. Now the last check I want to show you is the surface profile. We want to check this curved surface relative to the datum system BC. To do that, deselect the element group. I'll simply click the background in the 3D view. Open GD&T Quick Creation, Surface Profile. Use Control and the left mouse button to create the surface you want to inspect. Then click the right mouse button to open the check. Under Datum System, select the datum system BC. Enter the tolerance of 0.3 millimeters and then click OK to create the check. As you can see, the label is red, so there are likely areas with excess and or lacking material. To get more information about where those areas are, you can display a color representation across the surface. To do that, select the surface profile check and open the properties window. Click the tab Display and check the box Show Color Deviation Representation. Adjust the legend. Again, you can display discrete values by using deviation labels. But that's not everything. You can also display the minimum and maximum deviation label. To do that, select the check surface profile. In iInspect, open check. Press Ctrl and click minimum and maximum deviation label. This representation tells you if and where further machining may be required. That's it for this short introduction to GD&T inspections in ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D. If you want to dive deeper, check out the INSPECT GD&T Analysis Starter eLearning or the INSPECT GD&T Analysis eLearning. If you're looking for more comprehensive ZEISS INSPECT Optical 3D training, check out the INSPECT Optical 3D Basic eLearning. You'll find the links in the description below.